After EEVEE Next was released, I saw many enthusiastic comments from artists that EEVEE Next is replacement for cycles. I was impressed how many artists used EEVEE even before the new version, and I thought it might be really interesting to make something in EEVEE Next, something that I usually do in cycles, and see if EEVEE Next is really good for that. I made a huge test of EEVEE Next, and first what I can say that this real-time rendering is really impressive. With ray tracing it looks amazing right into the viewport. It allows us to work on projects in real time without noisy picture or waiting for the noise update. And it's really cool to work with materials, details and textures and see the final artwork right into the viewport, which is really helpful in the working process. But let's take a closer look at EEVEE Next and landscape in Blender. My main goal was to test EEVEE Next on some real landscape project and look at whether the EEVEE can handle something like that. So we are in the Blender scene and firstly we have to switch to the EEVEE instead of cycles. And we of course must enable ray tracing as a new feature of EEVEE. By the way, I created this scene from scratch and uploaded the full masterclass on how to create this Japanese landscape using Blender, EEVEE and Photoshop on my Patreon and here on YouTube. This is a step-by-step masterclass where I am showing the whole process of creating this scene from scratch, including 3D modeling of the street, temple and the whole landscape using only Blender. If you want to learn more and get access to the huge Blender masterclass, all links are in the description to this video. But we start with lighting and for the main light source I choose HDRI from Polyheaven. I use Blender Kit, but here we also can find Polyheaven free assets. I just choose the resolution of HDRI and it will be downloaded and set as background light. In the beginning set the proper light, it's even more necessary to work with materials, because to make materials we also must see how they look in the scene with this light. It's important because the same materials in different light circumstances may work in different ways. And I would like to pay attention to how it's really fast everything working in real-time rendering in EEVEE Next. That's really impressive. And by the way, if I disable ray tracing we may see this difference. How the image looks good with ray tracing, even though now it's all in gray materials, we may see this a huge difference. I also wanna mention the new displacement in EEVEE Next, which undoubtedly brings more realism into the picture as well as ray tracing. I personally use displacement very often when working with environment and landscape in Blender. Just like in cycles, we need to enable displacement and bump in shader settings and make sure that the density of the mesh is sufficient for displacement details. Usually we may add a subdivision modifier in the Blender to increase the density necessarily to displacement details. But keep it in mind if your computer can handle huge density meshes. It's clear that working process in EEVEE Next is not different from that in cycles. I used Megascans texture almost everywhere in this scene for rocks, stairs, temple and landscape because they provide a good displacement map for the material and I was interested in how displacement in EEVEE Next works and can I achieve nice result. But here is one thing that I wanna pay attention to. If you are downloading the maximum size of the texture in 8K and getting used to enable and simplify to resize texture like me, EEVEE Next doesn't have this feature in simplify. Since I use simplify in the default Blender setup, I noted that only after making all materials in the scene and understood that EEVEE requires almost 15 GB of video memory and everything was freezing in the viewport. I had to change all textures in the project to 4K and after that everything already works well. This is a small detail, but keep it in mind that may lead to some performance problem and your video card may suffer in some huge project due to this issue. But it's also worth to say how convenient to work with the complex materials in EEVEE Next. I mean blending textures in real-time viewport. This really works amazing. For example, here I wanted to make the roof material more complex, because the standard material with just textures looked very simple. In general, if you want to achieve realism in your artwork, it's worth creating some more complex materials, like adding dirt with additional textures or using ambient occlusion. It will give the material more realism, because in real life it's difficult to find a completely clean roof. The rainfall, sun, wind and dust will do their job, and in reality, the roof will have corresponding details in the form of dirt at the intersection of the object that we can do using ambient occlusion in Blender. But using the color ramp, we can change the color tone of this dirt to achieve the right effect on the roof surface. And I really like how it works in real time in EEVEE Next. Working with materials in EEVEE is very convenient, and suddenly, with appearance of ray tracing, realistic materials are approached to cycles. Of course, with the proper settings of these materials. In cycles, we are working in interactive render, but however, it's not a real-time render. Here, no time for waiting for the render calculation and the noise data. Everything works in real-time right here and fast. So, this is a big advantage to EEVEE, but also there are some disadvantages, and I will tell you about them. Do not forget to press the like to this video and subscribe if you haven't not subscribed yet. But we are returning to the lighting in Blender, and also we need to add some atmosphere to our render, to turn this boring one into stunning artwork. And as you may see, I still working in real-time rendering in 3D viewport. I wanted to create a morning atmosphere where the light just touches a little bit of the temple and some mountains behind the temple. It could be some lonely ray of light, perhaps passing between mountains that we do not see, somewhere behind the frame. For this, I add simple mountains to create a shadow on the foreground and partly cover it with the shadow part of the temple. This light also emphasizes the displacement details. Despite the displacement impacts the geometry and creates the real details, not a fake like a normal map. To see these details more clearly, we need the right light which will emphasize these details. Next, what I want to add to this artwork is fog, to achieve a foggy morning. First, I need fog above the water. This is going to be a simple principled volume. I just adjust the density so that it's not very dense fog, but still details should be visible in this fog. In this case, the color of the fog depends on the main light source. So that is not so reddish like this, I can pull the color in principal volume towards cold, to the opposite side of the red color. This will compensate the color value of this fog. Also, I planned to make a fog behind the temple, and that the mountains would be slightly visible. That's why I didn't detail the mountains material, because the idea wasn't to show them, but to use them for the silhouette. But to make sure that the fog behind the temple wasn't flat, I found these clouds in Blender Kit, which I used to create a background like a floating mountain effect. But the fog I decided to make in compositing, as I showed in on one of my videos on the channel. This is a simpler way to add fog using the mist pass or depth pass. Using mix color mist pass as a factor, I can freely adjust the color of this fog that I need. In general, EEVEE real-time rendering works well, and I could add fog by adding volume fog as well. But as for me, I prefer to do this in compositing because it's much faster and easier for any adjustments. Alright, what about render time? The time of the rendering in EEVEE Next was 20 seconds, which is really impressive because cycles spent 1 minute and 42 seconds. But you may notice that the cycles also has trees and grass in this scene, and this is one problem or even that disadvantages that I talked about before and that I personally encountered in EEVEE Next. I also added trees on mountains in EEVEE scene, but the problem was that everything worked well in real-time rendering, but the final rendering itself took endless time and I couldn't make a render with trees in EEVEE Next, like in Cycles. Bushes and grasses are possible, but it looks like a lot of vegetation is not a lifting task for EEVEE Next, or it will take a huge time in rendering that already makes no sense, because the same trees for the background I can easily add using mud painting in Photoshop. In this case it could be competitor to the Cycles, but only if the time difference is not too huge in favor of one option or another. In other words, we can freely use EEVEE Next for landscape, but within this some limitation, like using simple texture instead of grass and making details with displacement like small rocks. In any case, do not forget that any render can be turned into an amazing artwork in post-production. We can add effects, draw details and make color correction, and it will become a cool artwork. Since I also made a render in Cycles for the test, I just used this layer and mask to add some trees for the background on the mountains in Photoshop. Also, it can be done using some photos from photo stocks, as I showed in one of my videos on the channel. So, my personal conclusion is yes, EEVEE Next can be used for even complex landscape and projects. Also, at this point, EEVEE Next couldn't handle the forest. It's not such a big problem to avoid, for example, render time in 20 seconds. I don't even think it makes sense to compare this with Cycles. Just the render time in 20 seconds. And considering that, in combination with Blender and Photoshop, render in EEVEE will be ready before you make a cup of coffee. It's already cool. And the details can always be added on post-production or in compositing. Besides, not always need a lot of details, you know? Sometimes the time of the render or all performance is more important than even realism. As an example, if you are making a concept landscape, it's more important to see the result quickly and get the render fast for further work in Photoshop. Mud painting will do its job anyway, but you can spend the saved time on something else, such as learning something new to raise your skills. Also, we must understand that each rendering gene is suitable for certain tasks and projects, and even in such projects that was an extreme test of EEVEE Next, squeezing out everything that EEVEE can do, we can see that EEVEE is pretty good, especially convenient for working in real time. But is it a replacement for Cycles? Exactly no. I know many people wrote me on Instagram that it's good that EEVEE Next has been released and I'll forget about Cycle. I'm not sure if it's the right conclusion, but I guess there are two different engines in Blender, and it's great that we got EEVEE with ray tracing and displacement. So we got more freedom for creativity now, and I'm happy about that. Anyway, write your thoughts about it in the comments below. Also, if you want to access the full masterclass of EEVEE Next, follow the links in the description. If you want to support my channel, you may consider subscribing to my Patreon and get access to exclusive content as well as support with membership on YouTube. Many thanks for your support. Have a good one and see you in the next time.